review everything on the review of these notes. Now let's go on to learn how to draw these notes. When we draw these notes, we have to draw it in three parts. First of all, we have to draw the note head, and then we have to draw the stems, if they are stems. And finally, we'll go on to draw details. So let's see how to draw note heads. As already said, these are the parts of that make up a note. Here we have the note heads. You see the arrows pointing to the note head. So you see this note head here. You see this note head here that is shaded. You see this one here that is not shaded. And finally, you have this one here again that is shaded. You can see the stems. This first one doesn't have a stem, but this note has a stem. This one has a stem. And this one has another stem. And finally, you see what is known as the tail or the flag, okay? So those are the parts that make up a note. Let's go ahead to look at how to draw a note head. When we draw note heads, we can either center it on a line or space of the staff. So this is what a note head on the space of the staff looks like. You see it's sitting between two lines. And this is what a note head on the line of a staff looks like. It's sitting directly on top of the line. Note heads drawn on the space of a staff must touch the line above and below. As you can see, this note head on the space is touching the line that's above and the line below. Note heads drawn on a line of a staff must be divided into two halves. And again, as you can see, this note head sitting on the line is divided into two equal parts by that line. Remember to shade note heads when drawing crotchets and quavers. And basically, that's how we draw note heads. Let's look at how to draw stems. When the note head is below the middle line or the third line of the staff, then the stem will go upwards from the right side of the note. So you can see this note head is below the middle line. This is the middle line right here, and you see the note head is below that middle line. Now every time you have a note head below the middle line, then your stem will go up to touch that middle line and probably even go beyond that middle line. And that's how we draw stems. This time around, when the note head is above the middle line of the staff, the stem will trail downwards from the left-hand side of the note. So here you can see the middle line of the staff. And you see this time, the note head is above that middle line. So you see the stem trailing downwards to touch the middle line and probably even go beyond. And that's how we draw stems. So far, we have seen how to draw note heads. I've also taken a look at how to draw stems. Now, quickly, let's take a quick look at how to draw tails. This is the fun part and the easiest part of it all. The tail of the quaver will always point to the right-hand side and never to the left. So as you can see, I have a quaver here and its tail is pointing to the right-hand side. Same thing when that quaver is upside down. You can see its tail is pointing to the right-hand side. And that brings us to the end of how we draw the parts of the note. In summary today, we have seen that the symbols that are used to show note value include the semibrief having 4 beats, the minim having 2 beats, the crotchet having 1 beat, and the quaver having half a beat. And here we can see how to draw the parts that make up a note. When we draw those parts, we have to do it in three parts. We begin with the note head, we go on to the stem, and then we draw the tails or the flags. Remember that when you draw the note head, you can either draw it on a line of a space, or you can draw it on, I meant to say on a line of a staff, or you can either draw it on the space of a staff. When we draw stems, note heads that are below the middle line will have stems going upwards, and note heads that are above the middle line will have stems going downwards. When we draw flags, whether the note is right side up or it's upside down, the flag must always point to the right hand side. And that brings us to the end of the class today. I hope you had fun. See you in the next one. Bye.